Hello, this is Jer. This is the Nightmare series of Oxygen Not Included. I'm on the radioactive ocean asteroid that is metal poor and has a frozen core. Absolutely terrible place to be. As if it wasn't bad enough, all the game settings are on the maximum hardness, and we don't have teleportation or care packages. Enjoy! Welcome back. So I've added a new cooling line that goes all around the bedrooms. So that's going to keep them at a good temperature over time. Overall, it's looking pretty green around the base, which is good to see. We've got some cold area down here, which we definitely want because that's where the sleet wheat is growing. Down here is less important because the dupes are in atmosuits, but we do need to make sure that it's comfortable for the machines, or at least the machines don't break at this point. I did remove this guy here from one of my power plants. I don't think I need these all the hydrogen generators tuned up, so we're only going to tune up half of them. And I'm starting off today by putting a planned incubator. So I had this little incubator for general eggs. Now I'm going to have a dedicated one for these slug eggs. I'm going to put that right here. I'm going to put this in the heavy watt wire line, and I just remembered that you don't need a bridge if you build this guy like this. It kind of acts as a bridge, I guess, so that's nice. Take advantage of that, this location. And I've got these hanging down, of course, just for these guys when they're sleeping. They're giving the base a little bit of power during the nighttime period. As I'm working in this area, I noticed that I had a missing spot right here for the fire pole. That's because I had rovers earlier. And let's make sure we don't get rid of this one. I no longer depend on rovers because we've got 18 dupes. And that's just not necessary anymore, so I'm going to patch that back up. Looks like we've got this guy in place. It doesn't have any power, but I'm going to go ahead and do a slug egg. So engineer has given this guy a hug after plugging this thing in. And we move this egg, hit incubate again. Should get a new egg this time, and someone else will give that a hug. Astronaut is putting in another egg. Giving that a hug. Move that here in a second. Now at this point, if I do another one, I'm going to get this one just because it's on this side. And if I hit incubate, there's a good chance a dupe, if they're coming this direction, is going to pick up this egg. I didn't actually intend to put the incubator at the far end for this reason, but now that I look into this, let's actually see if that happens. I think this might actually be a perfect place at the far left. Unless I get lucky, a dupe's running this way to grab an egg. Oh, here we go. Scrubber, that's doing exactly as I had predicted there. Someone else may have to do the hug, though. Baker is on it. Still giving this egg a little hug. And I'll have 3 incubated eggs. So from this point on, the only thing is, all the eggs that are here are anytime I get eggs that are dropped off here, this one that will already be have the lullaby effect in the future is going to be picked up instead. Well, I may not use that all that often, but if I ever see eggs, I'll just go and do that for the time being. Or I could look at building more than one. Maybe I'll come back to that. Decided why not make this area set up for 3 incubators. Let's get rid of this. We'll twist the tube around and we'll start with that construction inside here. Begin with the first one, which is going to be located right here. The second one. And give each of these some power. Let's reconnect this tube over here. OK, can build in another incubator, probably. Oh, I still have a little Wi-Fi. Okay. Get a final one here. Can get rid of these two guys. What I think I'm going to do to minimize the time that these guys are on is just have a switch to turn them all on and off together. Locate that right there, the automation wire going through each of these guys. So this area is now built. I'm going to incubate each of the eggs. Should have an egg loaded at each one of these. If they have a little by effect on them all, I'll turn this off. We'll see what we get once the eggs are in. So we've got one, two, and about to have three eggs in. They all have the lullaby effect right now, so I'm going to turn this off and I'll come back once we actually need to run these machines. So waiting for my rocket Morpheus to return. It says out of destination, but it can actually land here, and then we'll just use gravity to get this thing to fall down. See that the lullaby effect has gone off on one of the eggs. Come back when there's more than one. So this guy doesn't have a lullaby effect. This guy does. I'm gonna turn this on. And we'll start the incubation process. Why don't we up the priority to get this done so I can get this turned back off when everything has been when the lullaby effect has been added to every egg. We've got the lullaby effect being applied on each of these eggs. So I'll turn this off and we'll begin work on another little project. Think I'll try to do a similar thing up here. I've dedicated ones for these Sweetle eggs. Start off building the first one here. I'm not sure about the flooding situation that this is going to cause, but we'll see in a second how this goes. Another incubator going in here, and I'm just going to find out if this is going to flood where I built it. Looks like not. Okay, right. That being the case, might want to have, I've got these plants that are sort of in the way, so I can't put them side by side. I can only get one on each of these slabs. Thinking the next one will go right here, but I've got this in the way that should be easy enough to deal with. I'll simply put one right there, and I'll put an incubator right here. But I've got to look at how I'm going to power these guys up. Could bring up heavy watt wire line. Can I build this right here without too much splashing down? I feel like I should be able to. Let's see here. If I put that right there. Find out if we get any splash down. Actually, hold on. Maybe that was a terrible place of the power. Oh, yeah. No. Good to notice that. Let's move that over one to the right. If I can get that connected, that will actually be pretty good. Look at that. We've got a new baby, what are they called in their younger form? Click on this. No, it's runner. Pugs, Sluglet. Okay. So they can either stay there till they're an adult, or I can click remove. Might as well remove them. And they're floating along. I don't think they provide any power till they're an adult, I believe, but, There we are, in the incubator area. Let's see, we've got some lead supplied up here. How quickly can a dupe replace this? Okay, that looked like minimal spill. Make sure we do a mop up. It's looking less and less like minimal spill, but no, I think we're okay. This is leading to a spill down here, and that is leading to a spill way down here. Engineers moving this conveyor loader over, so I'm going to click on this, hit copy settings, set the same settings there. We can now take this one out. This guy is going to need some power to that conductive line. Take down those two. This guy could be set up now. Oh, not that type. Here, I must have passed it. Where did I go? Ah, there we are. We've got two of them. Okay, so do that. One will move or add another machine right there. Now, one thing I didn't think about is light source. Okay, well, kind of out of space down here, but maybe it's not too late for these guys. Let's look at doing that. So I should be able to cover both of them. I think I'll have to have sort of a system like this that can look at each of these machines. And if someone is in either location, let's go to furniture. We'll give them a ceiling light. It's gonna cover both. That'll need some power. Let's up the priority just by one for each of these machines. Here we go. Incubator is being used on a sweet egg. They did that in the dark, but in the future they shouldn't have to. I guess the question is, do I just let this run all the time, consume power, or do I turn it off? Maybe in this case, get this guy running. I have another switch here. Maybe I'll put that up like this. Connect this like that. Wait for someone to incubate this before I plug this one in. Astronaut has incubated that one, so I can add automation wire into this. Need these for the time being. Got automation wire running through this, so I'm going to incubate both of these. Actually, in this case, the auto sweeper is picking it up. That's kind of cool. So that is running because I've got this switch on. But if I turn this off, they can wait until I choose to incubate some more. So I'm putting a clock sensor or cycle sensor right here. And I want to see if I can automate this even further because these buttons just are not going to do. Okay, now we're just waiting. Oh, lullaby effect. So we can turn that off. Up here, maybe we'll cycle the eggs so that we always incubate in the morning. I'll make them a higher priority thing. So if I want to automate this a little bit further, let's just say, okay, you know what? The dupes have got, let's say, 30, let me take it down, maybe 25% of the cycle where these machines can be on. That might balance the automation versus power usage. We'll see how this goes. Cool by effect. I'm not going to do this with all the critters. I'm only going to do this on the wild critters that I've got around. So that's the Sweedles and the Pugslugs. I think that is it. Every other critter I have is in a stable, so I'm not going to bother with an incubator with them. But I don't want these guys to disappear, or these guys either. In particular, I think it's more important for the Sweedles, because I'm getting a tiny amount of power. I mean, it's not, these guys aren't really that essential, but these guys are attending to my water weed. So definitely want to keep lots of them around. So with that set up, we'll see how this goes over time. I'll move over to my next project, which is to try to create some bleach stone with these critters. Now I'm going to need a new type. Also have a new stable and egg storing area. I'll start off choosing a space for that. So let me just choose this pickup. I'm thinking that location is going to be down here. So we'll start with the egg sorting spot, which is going to go right here. The door like this. Seal this off. We'll also have to deal with this power that's going around like this. Look at what I want. So I want to have a space and then two tiles. So we have a tile here and here. Okay. How about then we take our heavy watt wire line. We just tuck that down like this. Get that built first. We'll bring our heavy watts conductive line across like that. That line built, let's cut out this little section. One model essentially the same. It's pretty hard to see, but what do we have in here? We've got a drop-off spot. That's where eggs are going to be. Oh no, I can tell I'm gonna have a problem. I already know that I want to have this here instead, because I've got to send dropped-off eggs over here. Okay, the same issue when I built stable over here. I had to put the drop-off at the other end. Normally, I kind of set it up this way, where this guy's on the left. But because this little guy is in the way, that's not going to happen. That's all right. We're going to have another sweeper in here. Put that in right like that. Just realized that is the wrong type. That needs just to be the door that opens and shuts. Recognized. Door right there. We need something to tell us when we need eggs and when we don't. So it's going to be a critter sensor. Control this door. So if I'm setting up this area for the new types of puffs, I might as well start the process of removing eggs that are in here. There is a couple possible that could be put in there, but obviously that's going to be converted to meat. We don't want that. So what I'm going to do here is look for that particular type of egg that I want to save from that area. So Squeaky will have that dropped off at high priority. I might not necessarily use the incubator, but at least that gets that those types out of the danger. Okay, so with that, let's put another door right there. I have a spot here we're going to fill with water. Now, technically, we're going to lose this space, but I could redo down here if I want to get access back to that. So I'm not too concerned with that. Bring in some liquid. It would be easy to use the salt water. I think it makes more sense to use water if we can. Go up like this. little bridge over there. Probably gonna get this finished first, but just to be safe. Oh, they beat me to it. Excellent. So what else do we need? We're gonna have an auto sweeper that's gonna be just above this guy. So any eggs that fall out of it can fall into this water zone. We have to have an auto sweeper. Oh no, that's for the meat. The one that's inside this room. It's for the meat line. Which, maybe that'll be an optional one. We'll see if we do that in the end. But this guy, I know, has to be able to touch this guy at least when the door's open. So this needs to indicate when we're in need of eggs. So if we're below, let's say, 10. Which we are, that door should open. Accepting new eggs. Excellent. And I'm just wondering, technically, if I change... gonna have a door that goes like this. That's an optional one for the meat line. I'm just wondering if I did this to try to really push space to the left, orient it that way. Can I then? Should be able to. Okay, no, I see why I can't do that. Never mind. I was gonna try to make a door here to start my stable at this location, but we'll have to move over by one. Not a big deal. That there so that critters can't get out. Auto sweeper back. Make sure all these components have some power. Can either bring in the heavy watt wire line. No, I don't think that would make sense. Then we'll have a door. Wonder. I could, in theory, do... Oh, no, I couldn't do that. But I could put a door like that and make that two tiles part of my stable. I don't know that that really gives me much other than an oddly shaped... actually, hold on. I might have... might be able to take advantage of this. Okay. All right, let's do that. Oh, whoops. Okay, I see. I've got an issue... Should I do this one? Let's just take this out for the time being. Put in the stable, which is going to be on this side. I'm not always don't do that well as trying to figure out how big something needs to be. If I was going to have an even floor height of my floor, I mean, that's super easy. That's 96 right there. Counting in for the extra two that I've got right here and here. But I'm figuring I might as well go up here. Now, if I'm going to do that, we'll fill in that tile here because this is going to be filled with chlorine. So that's the gas that these type of squeaky puffs like. Let's try to get two more tiles back. It's going to actually even out for the missing two right here. So if I measure this out like this. If I went to here, that would give me 84. If we open this up, what is that? 21? That's over 100. So I definitely don't want to go this far out. But for the time being, let's just open this up. I'll do. Sometimes I find it just easier if I fill in an area. We'll see how... how much space we have if we just went up like this. So bring the door right here. Before I knock that out though, put something in place right there. I'll put in the first auto sweeper to collect eggs. In particular, I just want to make sure that this guy, I don't forget that it needs to access this right there. The auto sweeper. Maybe put the sensor down by one. Maybe I'll still do that. Okay, it's going to actually sit right there. You can tell the automation wire needs to go around that way then. Okay. Enough water. Let's turn that off. destroy that. Oh! Also noticing that the dupes earn their Atmos suit in this zone. Which isn't ideal because we're going to fill it with chlorine. They are going to be up here. I'm wondering. Yeah, definitely want to have that them enter from up here. Okay, that is good to know. I didn't actually consider that until just now. Sweep here, the sweep here. Or mop. Let's put in the loader that's going to collect some eggs. Simply sit right there. Take this down and send eggs into here. I think all this machinery should be fine and stable. Okay, well, with that, then... This might actually be a wall instead of a door. I've got to figure out, and I'm probably going to have another liquid airlock. This is a vacuum, I don't want to break that. But they're going to enter in such a way to not let chlorine out. Technically, chlorine would fall down, so I could kind of put that at equilibrium, maybe. But I don't think that would be the best thing to do. I think the best thing to do would be to create another liquid airlock up here. So as Cleaner digs this out, the ladder here so that we can get across. I'm having a look up here to see how I'm going to fit this in. If I could, I was going to try to put a liquid airlock in here, but I just can't quite see how this is going to fit in this particular area. So I'm going to actually move this door right here. But I think this might be an opportunity to kind of normalize or fix up this area. I've got these bending down just to make this a full 96 tiles. I could take these back. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I did that, that would give me a normal floor down here. But I could add an additional 5 over here, so... do that, and I'll have the dupes go down this direction at the same time. That will give me a little bit of space to put my liquid airlock. Because of the salt water geyser, I kind of limited it a little bit where I can put this liquid airlock. It doesn't work right here, because of reasons I already explained. That means that the other option, as far as I can see it anyways, is to put it right here. So we'll put this liquid airlock right in there. Fill this up with some sort of liquid. What line is that? That's the polluted water line. Let's not use polluted water. Connect into that later. And I've got to put a door here somewheres. This is what's going to keep the pips out. Filling in a few tiles. These guys might be crowded. For the time being, but I'll open this back up. I've got to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in here somehow. That should be pretty easy. We'll seal this off later. Take this out. We'll see how we are with size. Let's build the tiles here. Can open up this area here so we can complete construction, but obviously this opens up our stable at the same time, which we don't want to have happen. Take that out, we'll take that out. Don't know exactly where that leaves us in terms of where this needs to be, but we'll try right here. Try creating a ladder like that. Some pips are escaping. Wrangle them after. Okay, so with that door, where does that put us with our stable? Puts us one too many. Okay, I should have brought that up by one, but anyway, that's not far off. A little bridge here for Deep to get across. Get a ladder, go up and down, then we'll put this door in place up by one for from the previous one. So we'll put a ladder in right there. Start filling this with some water. This has already been filled back up again. Or no, it's still at 8. These guys are on this side of the door for the time being now. Looks like they're... Oh, come on, Pip. Come on, Pip. Ah, oh, well, almost made it. Okay, before I forget, I'll take these out to remind myself they don't have to stay that way anymore. A little bit of liquid here. Da-da-da-da. Do I care at all? Don't worry about that for the time being. Let's just put a ladder over it for now. Ladder's starting to fill up. Let's check that we still have our 96. There we are. Now, this guy. Careful here because that now needs to be lowered in order to reach. So that should do right there. Make sure it has some power. Can get rid of the other one. Down here, let's have a look. What would happen if we sealed that up? We're setting this up to be the chlorine area in here. This doesn't necessarily have to be part of the stable, though. But one thing we definitely want to do, before I forget, is to fill that in. Checking on my incubators. I might add another one over here. Oh, let's see that this needs to be moved out of the way if I want to do that. So put that right there. That's gonna mean we're gonna need to take over this power. But these guys are in here where these guys are not. I'm wondering if that has to do with the fact I have a drop-off station for pug slugs and not a drop-off station for these guys. Don't need this anymore. Let's take that out. Put a drop-off spot right there. So we have this area sealed off. I can now see it is 84 tiles, so we want to make it a bit bigger. I've got a couple options. One, I could either use this space here. A little bit concerned because I don't want to have critters way up here when I have to do some attend to them. Actually, speaking of which, let's put that in place later. This is also probably going to be where one of the eggs is going to be laid. Let's actually not put that in. And I think it makes more sense to push this whole thing over by one. So let's start that process. We're getting pretty filled up here. This carbon dioxide is not letting the water have it, but I'm gonna say we can stop sending water in anyways. I'm gonna open up this area. Now I'm gonna be very careful because I don't want to have cross direction between where the dupes can wear Atmos suits and where they can't. Actually, let's hold off just yet. What I'm thinking of doing is just to give, let's see, this space down here, it's normal height. Maybe I'll want to make that a room. We'll open this up. It will mean that I'll need a dedicated auto sweeper just for that little section, but that's all right. Morpheus has returned. Let's start charging it up. I should get a notification. No, that's not the right notification. I should get a notification from this guy that the rocket is ready to go again. Once rebels are charged up fully. Let's put in that drop-off station to see if we can get these guys freed. Put another incubator, locate it right there. Did some rewiring down here, so let's take this out. As well as this and this. Also realized I probably should have actually put this on the floor because there's a power line down there anyways. Okay, let's try putting this guy right there. Run some conductive wiring here and here. And hopefully this is close to 96. Okay, let me put in a drop-off spot for these guys. Where are they called? Sweetles. Oh, there it is. Let's also put in their other type, which is what? Grub wormling. Do that. Priority 7. So I don't know if. Yes. Okay, so that does make the difference. Fantastic. Okay. Which means that this could, another egg could be loaded in there. So that's disabled. I didn't know that eggs could be put in when this was disabled. Actually, knowing that little bit of information is helpful. But I'm going to design this guy for their grub type. Put that up to a 7. So that's an egg that needs to have the roll by effect added to it. That should be next morning. That should happen. Oh, so this is getting applied because I didn't have my automation wire to go over. Skipping this, that's important. And into that machine. With this built, we can get rid of this little tuck down line. Fill this in. I will disconnect this here and here so we can open it up from the top with Atmos suits. Fill that tile in and anxiously wait to see where we are with our stable size. So we've got Zookeeper creating that tile. Oh, okay. So 97. Perfect. All right. Well, I mean, that's easy enough to fill in a tile somewhere. So I think maybe there makes the most sense. We then need a door that goes down here. That's not going to give us an additional tile in the process. Think what, how to best do this. Maybe a door that goes across. Okay, open that up. Get a ladder going down. This needs to be changed out for a wall. So I actually don't want to have normal dupes over here anymore. Just looking at this setup, I've got a roll by effect that's been applied. I wonder if 25% might actually be too much or more than I need. Try taking that. Let's go with 21. So that should be setting or turning off just about now. Yep, there we are. Same thing should happen here once I've got that automation wire in place. Now, we don't want to trap a dupe in here, so I'm going to be very careful about this. We're going to put a wall right there and seal this off from the dupes without atmosuits. I was originally thinking putting my stable or my grooming station right there, but I forgot to, I'm not going to actually have that open. I have the ladder going down like that. Actually, that still probably is a good place actually for it, nonetheless. Put this right there. So this is sealed off, or will be soon. I don't know how important it is, but I'll build a pump up here just to get rid of the non-chlorine gas. Could either create a full vacuum, which I don't think is that important, actually, before I do that. But we sealed that off. So yeah, I could either create a vacuum and push in chlorine, or I could just not worry about it and take out, because oxygen is going to find its way up there. I mean, I think that makes the most sense. Pushing in chlorine first, and then taking this out over here. The only thing is that's going to require a filter, which is fine. A little bit out of room here, but let's just reroute that down. Speaking of which, let's connect into our chlorine line, which we have not made use of yet, or very, I shouldn't say haven't you made any use, very little use other than this setup for treating polluted water. Now I need to get across several of these guys. So we've got several oxygen lines. I can see that we have to move something around. This is the hydrogen line. Let's just go up like this. We got a carbon and oxygen line together. Let's move that carbon dioxide line over by one. Let's check on some of our rooms while we're at it down here. We've got a recreational room, we've got a washroom, great hall, massage clinic, nature reserve, hospital down there. Everyone has private bedrooms, recreational rooms down here. Looking good. Double check on this stable here since we made some changes. 96, looking good. Found a squeaky pufflet. Hopefully they're going to survive enough time for us to get some chlorine over here. Let's get down to the floor over here. That in like that, so I know that the dupes are going to be coming in from this direction, which is exactly what I want to see. Let's cut this right there. Put in the grooming station. Goes right there. Well, the only thing is, how am I going to do light? Thinking might as well put a fire pole here. I put a lamp right there. Does that reach? It does. Okay. So we'll put a dupe sensor then. How about right there? Oh. It's a little annoying. What about right there? Nope. Oh goodness. What am I going to do here? If I want to have an automated light sensor. Perhaps we put, oh, I know, we'll just move it to the left. Take this out. That's going to allow me to put a dupe sensor, say, right there. And I could put the light right there, so put the automation wire in for the time being. Did we make out? I probably should have cut this already, but let's cut this right there. This one is loading in from the top, actually, so I'm going to cut this one right there. So that's a disconnected pipe. Let's prioritize draining this line first. So that's going to allow me then, let's see, decide where I'm going to bring this through. Let's, we'll do that. Got some wild plants there, though. There, that's not actually part of the nature reserve anymore. We'll go up over here. Taking our chlorine across. Two jumps. So go up like this and over. Making sure we don't connect into our oxygen line and leak chlorine into our base. So I should be able to get over like this. And then like this. Just to make it aware that that's not actually used, we'll deconstruct this whole little section. Then I'll be able to jump over yet again. To decide, am I going below? Yeah, I'm going to go below the carbon dioxide line. So we'll go like this, and then like this. Making a cut right here. And a cut right there. We can put this back in place. Getting rid of the excess pipes again. And once I've done all of that, let's make sure we do this little connection before I forget. There, there, there. Then I can grow across. We'll go through here. Maybe I should have actually gone down that last little one. And then once I've done that, then I'll be able to another jump just before. But I could output. I could either do the high pressure or we'll just start with the gas vent. But I don't see why I couldn't do the high pressure one. Do that right there. Maybe not make this a plastic ladder. Have that go all the way down here. Fire pole, we'll put that in right there. And we'll put in our grooming station. Set right there in a central-ish area. Double check, we're still at 96. Yes, we're looking good. Oh, a little bit of liquid on the floor. Let's double check if that went down here. Seem like we're okay. So while I'm waiting for this gas line to go in, let's unlock new blueprints. What are we getting today? Ballet shoes. Okay, great. Let's make sure that we've got auto sweepers now on the floor. So we're covering up to this guy. So we need something that's going to go in. Let's put that right there, and I just need one that's going to reach over there. Then I need an autoloader, ideally just one that's going to reach in between the two. Let's just double check this guy can reach it, and that guy cannot, unless I were to actually make this go upside down. Or I could bring this down by one either. Ideally, I'd bring this one down. Just that we don't have eggs hanging out in here. So if I have the conveyor loader down like this, I can get the egg out. The stable all the faster. Not that that's probably going to be the biggest thing, but why not? So that's going to go across until all the squeak puff eggs are dropped off. Now we need an actual drop-off location. Might as well put that close to here. So maybe I should have actually tilted. I could even bring it one tile closer. Try to tilt that up. That looks like what we need. Let's just bring in some power. I can see heavy watt wire is going to make sense for this setup. Let's give him that extra conveyor loader. And we'll have the drop-off location. So if I get this built, I can see if I can wrangle that critter, if they're still alive. Hopefully Squeaky, Pufflet, wherever they are. But we do have eggs, if that guy didn't make it. Prioritizing getting some fluorine in here. Actually, I should really be using incubator now. Got three eggs. We'll do the first one. There you are. Let's wrangle you. We don't have anywhere. Oh, you know what? Actually, hold on. I'm gonna, instead of waiting for that drop-off spot, we'll just do this. Move to. We've got this going in. So has our chlorine made it? Has it made it there? We must have an issue then. What did we do wrong? Oh, no, we didn't do anything wrong. We just have to wait. Be patient. A few more pieces of pipe to go in. And I'm hopefully going to see this green stuff flowing. There we are. That's what I'm expecting. How much chlorine do we have? Good amount. That has all come from this guy over here. So we've got a chlorine vent somewhere, so you can see all the green around. This carbon dioxide geyser is going off at the moment. Oh, there's the chlorine geyser. So right now, it's mostly just carbon dioxide in here. But not terribly thick, so this guy has lots of room to expand some more chlorine once it's ready. Once that is sucked up into those pumps, that's pushed into one of these guys. This setup has just been running smoothly for the longest time, thanks to all this liquid nuclear waste. Let's have a look, see how radioactive that is. Still a good amount. That's bringing back chlorine, which ultimately is pushed into this guy. Oh, well then. I guess that we need a little bit of attention up here. Clear this off as well, because our mission control station doesn't work like that without a sight into space. Okay, maybe it was good to have a look at this. So, okay, now that we have this opened up, we should get our canisters going here. We should be able to get some chlorine and other natural gas, carbon dioxide, into there. Which is brought in, it does some sorting. Chlorine bit goes in there. So now, let's see. Did we get that chlorine from the other planet into this room? Not quite, because this room is overpressured. Interesting. Okay, well, I guess that is a reason then to get this going. This is actually going to be the opposite of what I would normally do, in the sense that I want to filter for chlorine and dump chlorine back in here, but send everything else out this room. Let's do that like this. So just make sure that we've got some power for this these machines. Where is our closest line? I could either bring up heavy watt, but I think it makes more sense to do this. Just make sure we don't go through these tiles here. Get rid of those wild plants. We managed to get a small amount of chlorine out, just as the gas is going around. Spent it out just enough so that the squeaky pufflet could take their first breath. Let's up the priority this. This is where I'm going to be dropping off just the adult version of the squeaky type. Squeaky puff. We want to have... Oh, that's right. We want to have one of the princes in here with all the automation. Forget about that. So let's make sure we set this to chlorine. Okay, so for the prince, then, I'm gonna move this over, put a drop-off spot. Actually, no, let's put the drop-off spot right here for the prince. And the logic for that, I think what I had set up over here has been working, so I'm gonna do the same thing. Which is all of this. Okay. So basically, I was saying if I am above 5, but also above 0, then allow that to run. Okay, I've got to study this a little bit before I set up how the layout. This guy is going to run. This guy, on the other hand, I think is pretty simple. That's simply saying... Oh, no, it's not the... Oh, okay, I've got an issue now, because this whole thing depends on, the fact that I've got one stable set up for these puffs, but now I'm going to have two. Okay, this might be a little bit of a challenge. How am I going to, okay, let's just concentrate on the easy side of it. So there's this setup, the drop off. That needs to be simply set up with a critter sensor that says if you are below 5, so I don't want to have every one of these to be the dense buffs. Want to save room for a prince, then you can let that machine run. So, okay, so that's the easy bit then. Let's put that in. So that connects to this guy here, which I see we're going to have an issue. Maybe not as easy as I had thought. Okay, let's put the sensor there. Now, I want to have a... Before I forget, drop-off location here. That's going to send eggs in. Like that. But here's the thing. Now I need to have an automation wire that visits this guy. But okay, actually no, it's not too bad. All I need to do is make those regular tiles, then I can connect it down, because I don't want to go through this door. That's the whole challenge. Oh, this is not so bad. It's pretty easy, actually. There we go. Okay, so that's gonna basically say, and I gotta set this up, make that priority. That's gonna be for our squeaky adults. Make that 0. Okay, so we've got that. Now what about the princess? Because this guy is not going to produce squeaky puff eggs without a prince. Or I think I know what we'll do. This whole setup I'll do twice. Plus the filter, and we'll just combine that at this location. Okay, so that means I'm going to have two sensors that have to be in the stable itself. So how about we go 1 and 2. After that, was that a AND gate? Okay. So those get combined in an AND gate. Then we had a filter. That filter go up like that. Thinking this should work. So we're going to push both that into the AND gates, this into this. Then this goes up, making sure we do not go through some of that tiling. Technically, I could go through that. Making my way up here. What is this wire that's still needed? That's for the pips. Gotta get across some way here. Bit of a traffic jam. Wonder if I just flip this guy over. I think that's the best thing to do. So we're gonna put that right there. Make sure we get a conveyor line going up. Make sure we've got some power. That should make it such that I can get that automation wire up now. Like this. So if I combine this, I'm only going to be wrangling when one of these buildings or stables is need. Squeaky type. I think that should be it. Starting to get more chlorine gas in here. What is the holdup? I guess we need some power. Just need to wait around for a little bit. Don't get too far. Let's prioritize on getting this to the bottom. So I see this guy is in the incubator. They're not being let out, so maybe I actually will add the non-adult types to be dropped off here, at least for the time being. I could probably get a little bit more done up here if I expand the number of Atmosuit docks. So that's definitely gonna be a priority, I think. Let's deal with this little piece of liquid. In fact, I don't really need it. Could just simply fill it in. Get that liquid out of there. I have lots of petroleum building up. I haven't made use of that yet. Probably take a note. Send that somewhere at some point. Either into some sort of application or some infinite store, perhaps. Not to worry about that. After we deal with these squeaky guys. Just checking on this setup. Got Sweetle Egg and a Grub Egg, both with a little bite effect. Good to see. Get this tile filled in so that's no longer liquid. Now I'm going to decide how I'm going to get up and around here. I think what we should do is put in the floor like this. I'll have a ladder, fire pole right here. Actually, I may have to take these guys out ideally. I think I'm gonna do that actually. So that we can get take advantage of this little space up here. Push this over as far as we can. If I'm gonna do that, we might as well make these plastic tiles. Laddering up here. Relocate these machines. Their only real purpose is to pick up eggs that get dropped off here from these guys. So I'm gonna try to keep this whole setup intact. I could move that actually to some other location, but it's not worried about that. See if I can get this in place right here. So we have a ladder going up. Let's put a fire pole in. Like that. Locate this guy. It's right there. Put in the tube access. come right here over in. Get rid of this. That new building has to have some power. I'm thinking we might as well connect into the heavy watt wire since it's so close. What was this old line? Guess that goes in multiple directions. Okay, I guess we can get rid of that little section of it then. Plug this in, and we're gonna have this whole, if we're gonna expand these guys, might as well go across like that. Figuring if I build this now, it's gonna allow more dupes to be up here, since I've got a lot of dupes that don't have may not have as important things to do out here. Let's make this the priority construction project for the moment. Notice this transit tube is going to be a bit of an issue for us because these critters don't seem to hang out down here at nighttime. So, not planned, but I'm going to bring this up around that way instead. Let's make some room out here. So, we're going to take all of this out of the way so we can expand our Atmo suit area. Put a new checkpoint right there, far over as we can go. Just make sure that we've got an oxygen and only an oxygen line before I put anything in, otherwise this could take some damage. So go across like this. We'll do the same set up here with this going up there, crisscrossing everywhere's to get oxygen in from two sources. Oh, stable problem down here. That is probably due to the fact that we've got too many. Hold on. We are ever above 8. How many do we have in here? We've got 9 critters? How'd that happen? Oh, okay, yeah, I see. That's probably exactly what happened. Good, okay, this is actually one of those cases where the alarm went off, and it was for a good reason. Copy that. We're also out of power. Automation going up, that's not to do with the power situation. I must have snapped. Ah! Right, okay, I didn't mean to actually take that out. So let's reconnect this. It's important. We're gonna actually connect this from there. I'm gonna put in a transit tube that goes up like this. Then what I was trying to do is get these to go across like this. Heavy watt wire line. Get that to go up in a different location. Put right here. Oh, we've got some stuff in the way. We need to wrangle you and get you out of there. To make it so that they can do it from down here, I'll put a ladder down. We're gonna wrangle you. I take this out, I think it's important we connect up the new line. It can go in this direction. Might as well bring heavy watt line all the way across here. We'll hold. We'll do that later. We're off by one. Do this like this, and let's do a disconnect right there. Just restocked a few suits here. Dupes don't have anything to do. I don't want to let them out because there is some dangerous places. Actually, you know what? If I just prevent them from going there, I think we'll be okay just to take this out. Actually, if I take this out, dupes aren't going to be able to cross here, but they can still go here. So that allows me to go do some things. Maybe I'll do that. Let's do that and turn this back in before I forget. I'm going to add these guys the full way across. Oh no, we can't move until this is actually built. Okay, we'll go as far as we can. One there. Gotta get this power section built. I think they should be able to reach, just to make sure. Damn, let's put a ladder there. Okay, ladder's in place, but it wasn't needed. But let's now take this out since we've got power going around the other direction. Get rid of that little section down here as well. Let's put in some plastic tiling just to help speed dupes along this direction. Hold on, do I have an actual... Oh, that was a mistake. Alright, let's go up over here, I guess. Build this finally. I'll start adding some suits. So we've got a stable problem down here. That doesn't surprise me since we've got this little bit of a holdup. It all comes down to this guy. Let's get that built, dupes. So since I've got several of these, actually, how do I have that? Oh, right, because there's, this guy here is needed. So once the dupes get out there, one of the things I would like to restore is this line here. Go in. Oh, no, it cannot. Aha. Okay, well. Well then. What to do? I think the best thing is to move these guys then. I was planning on having this go like out around like that. I guess we'll restore this tile. At least we can get one more than one of them there, but they're not able to access power. Actually, they can get across, but yeah. Huh. Unless there's a chance, and I highly doubt this is going to be the case, that we could go along like this instead. But I'd be quite surprised if that would be allowed, but we'll test anyway. So with this built, dupes are now able to get out here, so they're going to fix some of the stable problems that we've had. And then I'll reroute this to see if these guys can land when it's one above. I really doubt that's going to be the case. If not, just trying to see if I can avoid moving them. Maybe I go up here instead. Oh, but there isn't a lot of good options, to be honest. I'm also wondering if I should have actually lowered this. Actually, if I lowered this one, that would allow me to get some light down here. only thing is it's going to be a little bit of a difficult build. Make this out of plastic. I have to create a few holes here so that dupes can actually access it. This will be disruptive to incubators, but that's not really going to be that big of a deal, I don't think. Did we ever get that power restored? We did. Oh, hold on. Let's make sure we get that back. Make that the priority. I don't know, but I have a feeling like these guys are going to have a hard time overlaying with these buildings. Find out if that's going to be the case or not. If I can get these down, I could send the pipe up and above them. So if I did that, then I might struggle to get some light in there. I'm gonna go look to see if there's a better place to put these guys. Let's see about moving this transformer up one. And I'm gonna put these guys, start the relocation process. I'll still have that as plastic tiles there anyway. But the new tiling can go here. I want at least one tile for each of these guys. I think we've got four right now. So this is going to give us six, which is perfect. So these guys can't get out this way. They can't get out this way. Get this back and open that up. Set that right there. Take out a spot for a new transformer. Ladder going up like that. Since we have a new transformer going in there, we need to bring this up. Engineer's taking that out, so now I can put in the transformer. Get rid of some of these ladders down here. While I'm moving these guys, I guess I might as well reconnect this pipe. Tube is now online once more. I'm going to bring in some of these incubators. We'll do the same plan, we'll make three. Actually, we'll want at least one more spot now that I think about it. Let's make sure we take that out. Let's have automation. Let's check where the dupe actually stands. They stand to the left. So we're going to have a sensor here slightly to the left, so that's going to be good for all those three. We'll now have a light access up here. Now let's do the lab flask for this setup. We're going to want some power in there for that. We're going to want some power in for these guys. And we will want a drop-off spot for critters like this. That's going to go there. We also want to pick up the eggs that fall down here. Deciding to use plastic. Let's be careful. That's not actually where the floor is meant to be. So wherever these guys are, I'm going to make sure we've got a floor because that's potentially where eggs would go. I wonder if there's a chance that they'd fall down the side. That may be true. Let's account for that. Where I was storing in, maybe we'll bring in a new auto sweeper. The bin of ready to go Atmos suits right there. We'll need an auto sweeper down here. Just dedicate it towards picking up eggs. I'm going to create one more tile. Better do that. And we're going to bring in a loader. Let's see, where can I get this in? Let's put that right there. We'll need a bridge. Do that so we can squeak up to here, drop off eggs. Put in the same setup with automation for these guys, so I think simple cycle sensor is going to be perfect. Say, what is going on here? Dupes have made a mess in the rocket. They can definitely leave the rocket. But can they get from the rocket down here? That means two things. One, they must have backed up washrooms. Oh, not backed up. Okay, they're not allowed to use those washrooms. Okay, looks like they're able to get out now. There must have been a path. Oh yeah, probably something around here that they couldn't get across. Maybe they still can, actually. That being the case, let's make that. So yeah, they can get up there through the tube, but they can't get back down. Okay, that is a bit of an issue, but that's going to be fixed very soon. So with those tiles made now, we can get tubes back. They're probably urgently trying to get to the toilet. Found one of you guys here. Let's move you into this stable. Thinking I may have just made a few spots where these critters can't create some power. Just going to make sure that we build this auto sweeper a little bit lower so that they can get in there. Same thing with the loader. The loader right like this. And that sensor for time. Could either bring that down, but I'm wondering if I could just bring it up instead. Go up like that. Let's also bring in the heavy watt wire line that can go across like this. Might as well visit these two machines. We've got escaping slugs. Oh, they... He accessed some metal there. That's not ideal. It's going to produce some hydrogen. Not really going to be a problem for that, but let's get them brought back up into this zone for the time being, and then we'll move them all over this new place. Looking at the oxygen situation, this line's not doing anything. And then if I scroll down, I can see why didn't have this set up correctly. Let's get rid of this gas bridge. So this is the line we should be feeding into. So I'm gonna put a gas bridge right there. I was wondering why those Atmos suits weren't charging up that quickly. I'm going to now copy the settings from here, put that over here, and get rid of this one, and the incubators as well. And I can do wrangling, and all the critters that are here can be brought over here. Make sure we don't have any more down here. We do. We've got one. To start to consume my metal if I let them run around wherever they want. So this is going to be designed for critter eggs. And I guess we have to go down a little bit further with our conveyor line. So I still want that clock sensor, but I might want to relocate it up here somewhere. Here we go. This should give us more oxygen supply to this, since we're now actually feeding in from two lines instead of one. So that's important. Let's have a look just to make sure these guys are happy, not getting too hot. A little warm, but it's managing. So that has a cooling line from the system down here. Still haven't done anything with this. We just got a cool brine making its way down here. Did not take too long to relocate these guys. So I'm going to open up this so we can make this actually go flat across. It's bringing power line up in over here. It's going to allow me to get rid of this little section. Get rid of some tiles down here. Making room for the new plastic floor. So technically, I guess we don't need to have that go all the way up, except for, I guess, if dupes are coming from this direction, actually, maybe. This, in fact, make one more plastic ladder. They're going in that direction. So we don't need that anymore. Or the conveyor line, for that matter. We can get rid of that whole little section. Needed to wrangle these guys so many times. Let's try this again. Wrangle you. Now, I only have one dupe that can go over in here. But you know what? Let's, take that system off, dropping squeaky eggs down there. Okay, there it is. Rancher's taking that career out, so that's good. Someone's going to wrangle them. Bring them up here. Let's see if the construction... Oh, we've got our chlorine. Okay, let's not waste power and have that continue to run. Actually, I see a little bit of oxygen. Must have literally just taken the last piece. Oh, there's still a little bit left there, but you know what? I'll just give that, Oh no, where'd it go? Oxygen, if I let this be connected. I may have just arrived actually at the perfect time to notice this. So that might be the last piece of oxygen or pieces of oxygen on the way out. I was thinking about putting in an automation system to be notified of this, but it just kind of worked out quite nicely. Having an extra piece of oxygen is really not going to be an issue, because technically this is outside the squeaky stable. Yeah, we are going to be good with that. Oh! What is... Oh yeah, that's just the... I was like, what is this? Right, that's just the chlorine going back. So we'll take all this apart. But actually, that's not why I came into this zone. I came into this zone to see if this was built, and it was not, so we will keep waiting. But how are you guys doing? Good, let's set this up for critter eggs. And critter eggs. See if we've got any squeaky eggs here. None at the moment. Actually check to see. We've got none there. Okay. They're all... Got one or two over here. Maybe we'll do an incubation cycle. Oh, and I see you. Excellent. Move you over here. I think I've got one final thing I'd like to do today. That is reroute that tube. copy the settings here. That can go into the cycle. Let's see, where am I? I'm up here. That goes into this cycle. That means we can get rid of this one. My thinking is, let's take this out. In fact, we'll take that whole line out. Actually, before I do that, let's build in the existing, or the new one. So that's going to go up like this. And then over. The reason I'm doing this is I'd like to get an auto sweeper to reload these guys. I was thinking of putting a bin here, but that might be a little bit of a challenge for this to be able to access. So that's why I'm thinking I'll need some space right like that to access those guys. Put my transit tube across like this and into that. Okay, I just noticed that this is a mix of oxygen. I guess it's not really the end of the world. But maybe what I want to do is put a pump over here. Could either do that, or I destroyed all that those pumps up there, didn't I? Ah. Okay. If I can actually put in a vent over here. The only thing is I've got that automation wire that's kind of in the way. We'll try just venting there, see if that's going to be enough. Go across like this and into here. Let's see what that does. So given enough time, it probably is having a difficulty getting that. Well, actually, if it gets up there, it shouldn't have an issue. I'm kind of surprised it's just stuck there at the moment. Oh. Oh. I did not see you. Okay, well, that explains what's going on then. We don't want to push in oxygen anymore. That was, so we are getting oxygen here. So this is going to be the end of the line for that setup. Okay, all right, that was good to notice. So this guy's for the princess. I think that's this one. Prince Puff, let me copy this setting. That into there. Okay, maybe we will rebuild this after all. And I thought I got there at just the right time. I probably didn't. It was probably just a new piece of oxygen that made it up. But anyway. What is going on? You need to be connected like that. There we go. High pressure right there. Well, I thought this was going to be the last thing today. I'm going to aim to fix that issue we've got up over there with the squeakies. Let's take this little section out. I'm not 100% sure if we've got a connection or not. Go. I think we should be good. Take that out, take that out, and take that out. So these are built. So I can do the same settings here for the Prince Puffs. So one says 64. What? Did that get changed? That couldn't have been right. Okay, let me think about this. If we are looking at... should be critters, right? If the critters are... above... be above 4, right? No. Okay, this... I was just going to copy the settings, but I'm not happy with the settings that are currently there. Going into here, let me think about this. Okay, so what this logic should basically say is equal to 5. If I have exactly 5 of these guys, is that the case at the moment? We've got five critters, but I see a prince in there already. Which isn't making a lot of sense. I should get one more. So I should get a true signal down here. That is being read in from this guy. So this guy says if you are below six. So now that's sending a true signal. I'm going to wait for, I don't see, oh, there is one more, or at least one dense puff in there. Okay, so there's that. The other thing is this whole setup here might not actually work until this stable is populated with enough critters. Currently there's four, so actually only need one more. So if we could get this to be complete, that would be nice. But over here, I guess we can get rid of this. Not as concerned about airflow up here, so we can seal this off. But let's put in our auto sweeper. And I think this is the first time I'm going to ever use. And when I saw this originally, the storage, I thought, I'm never going to use that. It's kind of useless. But here we are. Oh, needs to be moved over by one. Another sweeper on this side. Make sure they both have some power. We're getting rid of that last little oxygen that we were spilling here. Well, I should say last little bit, not entirely true. I guess we have to wait for that to find its way over. I'm gonna disconnect this one. For now, at least. Maybe I will put in automation here, so if I detect oxygen, this guy can run. Reroute that. Okay, so this is the logic that indicates whether we need any more of these guys. No, wait. That's, or yeah, the print, that's the Prince Puff line. This guy should be turning off when I look for oxygen. So we've got that egg going. Got an auto sweeper going on here. Zookeeper, what are you doing on the floor? We've got private bedrooms for you guys. Okay, so with this. Whoops. We're gonna put in, what is the max? 1,000. That will be plenty. We'll put, I'll take it down to 5. Atmo suits. Make that a high priority storage. Filter not designated. Selected Atmo suit, right? Okay. Oh, someone have to actually click on it. It's not like, okay, fair enough. All right, someone has to, anytime I change this, I guess the dupes have to go and do something. Whatever, that's fine. Let's see if they actually store anything in it is the next question. Do they have to stand right above it, or can they access it from, I'm assuming they could access it from down here. Though we may not have, we may not have spare suits. That might be the whole thing. But as these are taken down and being brought, I think it's down here for repair. Once they're dropped here, I should see a dupe or two bring that up here. How many of these do we have? We've got 18 dupes. 14 of which can actually go up in space and into this zone, so that's much better than before. No, we create two more. Gonna set this to look for chlorine. That's not breathable. So, oh no, wait a minute. Oxygen, oxygen. I should have went for to breathable, actually. So right, hold on, shouldn't that be true? There it is, good, exactly. So that should slowly take out of the oxygen and I don't have to be around for that to be turned off. Let's just have a look here. Did I actually apply the settings? No. So I want this to be when it's exactly 5. So if you are, I don't think we want to look at eggs. We just want to count the critters. If you are below, this is, if you're above 5 and below, no, above, above 4 and below 6, you must be at 5. And if you're at 5, the assumption is, hopefully, we've got 4 of these guys, regular puffs or the dense puffs. If that's the case, there's one more spot for a single prince. I'm going to try with the same logic down here and we'll see what happens. So copy this. Hold on, no, not the actual device, just the settings. Copy settings. Copy settings. Let me just double check that I didn't click copy the same thing. So below 6. Oh yeah, I did too, didn't I? Below 6 or above 4. All right, lots of little changes in this area. Let's just make sure I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 5 of those guys, that's cool. We've got these new Atmo suits in place down here. We've got incubators for some of our wild critters. And we've got this new squeaky area. I don't see any bleachstone. Oh, I probably won't see bleachstone. I've never thought about it. But I'm storing that at high priority somewhere. Oh, right here. I might want to change that. Or have an auto loader take that in somewhere. So anyway, I think that might be another day's thing, though. But thanks for watching. Hopefully, I will see you next time where I continue on. I've got more dupes that can go out here. So that allows me to do more construction and experiments out in this zone. Let's look to see where our rocket is. We are still charging up with that. But very much be interested in going on another space mission soon. See some meteorites about to land. So why not close that? All right. I will... I was curious, what was... Oh! We have taken damage. That's interesting. I did not... Now, is that due to heat or just slam? I'm assuming that's slamming. Okay, I've never noticed that before. I don't know what I'm going to do about that, but that's... I can't get into that today. All right, I will see you next time.